ifako ijaye, ifako ijaye television. Ifako ijaye, ifako ijaye television. Bangba la janta awo ki lumo, Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade oki ojo teye keye.
Page 46, there is a said you are man of small bottles.
After that, you saw.
Yes.
No doubt.
That is what I have explained to you here. Mm-hmm. The amount of money released was not up to 16.
It was just that
16 million was appropriated by 2.5.
Sorry, I'm coming to you. Let me just say this for our viewers' sake.
Okay.
As long as we keep shifting blames or trying to implicate people only when they are against us or against our political ambition, as long as it is only then that we now realize, oh, he has a dossier, you now go to the ICAN and start to, and Nigeria will never move forward. Okay. How come 3 years after?
Okay.
I want you to understand more further. Because of what you just said, that we should not try to shift blames on maybe past or when we're being attacked. Mind you, somebody that put a finger in your mouth does not expect anything other than for you to bite it.
To bite, yes. Thank you very much. You are right.
Okay. Comrade,
I've taken my time to listen to my comrade, and I really enjoyed all the explanation.
And the analysis.
Yeah, the analysis.
The
aspect that I want to throw more light
on
is this. You see, when this report was read out for us, he came up and said it's one-sided. Now, he said the anchor men should have given Obasanjo's side
of the story.
The two persons that spoke in regard to the response for Obasanjo, I listened to them. And what they all said is nothing different from what we had. And because, you know, and I expected them to talk, because they are part of who that shared this money. So, and it's high time for them to quickly come out and give us some
friends.
They share the money on the day. So now, what I want to say
is this.
What I want to say is this. You see, EFCC, ICPC, and the constitutional institutions that are known under the law give their own reports on this issue based on findings and investigation regards to this money. And now the spokesperson of Obasanjo and the other guy, Manika Ode, and the other guy came up and said their own side. What I think they ought to have done, if they know that all these reports that were read out for us are lies, I expected them to go to court.
Yes.
You don't even need to wait for Warren. I'm coming. No, he said go to court.
For defamation.
For defamation of character.
Was the name mentioned?
I'm coming. No, but somebody came out. See, when you are talking, I don't interrupt. I give you the time to talk. And please, then give me my own time to talk. I always tell you this. You see, that's why when we have this issue of brand, everybody started talking. Buhari, what has he been looking for the past 3 years, things and that. And you know that if we want to, money is assigned for something, actually, we have procurement laws.
Sure.
We have processes that one has to take before all this thing. This 20 years now, we're talking about 1999 to 2007, till this present year that we are. And if those things were rightfully initiated as many of the projects that PNB is finishing today being initiated by either Jonathan
or Pastor
Christian, but at least they continue from where they left it and this serious government is finishing up with them, I didn't mean those money earmarked for this power, $16 billion, passed through the normal processes and the spending were done the way it should be done. By today, the former administrations supposed to have finished implementing those things. Now, what we know is that this money was earmarked and the money was eaten. That was why we can cannot trace anything that has to do with this project. And now, when the present administration came on board and asked just a simple question, everybody started talking. And even the person that felt this man is referring to came up and
also
and directed us, to a page of his book. Is the book the Constitution of Nigeria? Because the question I ask is this: if you know that this thing is directed at me, and you know your hands are clean, and you know somebody is trying to malign you or ridicule you, your name, it's not bad for you to go to court and challenge and clear your name.
Okay.
You gave him more than that. So, what we need to do is this: not by blaming Buhari for coming up with this issue. What we should do is that the institutions that are legally approved to do this investigation should go on and conclude and let us know
where the let me quickly ask Comrade one question. Don't you think that Comrade Shumaye Taiwo has a very valid point when he said, okay, the House of Representatives, they submitted the report, they sent it to the EFCC and ICPC.
Yes.
And why is it that up to today, no changes has been proved?
Yes, he has a valid point. And I've said it when I was talking, that you know, many of what this present government is doing now are all initiated by the NPP. And this part of this investigation and the rest were being initiated by PDP. And we have that hope.
We
the people of Nigeria, that while we still finish up
this one
as it's finishing other ones. You know, a lot of things that are being implemented by PDP while this government is finishing on it. You know, like roads
and
from what Engineer Shoni said earlier, he said that one should not, whenever one is attacked, you shouldn't come out and be saying these are. I think this is not the first time issues like this will be coming up. You know, when they said that some people looted the Nigerian money and other people were clapped, most especially they demanded for it. And when those names were published, they started dragging them to court of law and saying these sort of things. I think it's going to be better for them to keep quiet. Don't request, because when you request something and it is being given to you, don't complain that it's poison.
Okay.
It's rather for you to.
Before we go on,
I want to react to what you said. As regards somebody going to court for malignancy, the issue is this, and for OBD referring people, Buhari to his autobiography. The issue is this: President Buhari was not direct to any individual.
Yes.
Good. So, and in the response of OBJ too, in a diplomatic manner, it did not direct, never mentioned him. He just said, whoever that cared to do or that is saying this about the power problem wants to know where the $16 billion is or where the power is, should go back to Nairobi.
Automatically,
so it's like they are sending themselves, you know, Buhari said that finally, I think President Buhari will do this nation good by either revisiting this panel, revisiting all of what he has the power, he has the prerogative, or the report, because according to Obasanjo, that EFCC had done their probe and absolved Obasanjo of any complicity.
Is a lie.
That is what he said. He did not make sure he
was saying that, because I know it's a lie.
You know what you have said is a lie. You have access to the report.
Ah.
Now, if you want to know is a lie or not, it is now left to the FCC to either start afresh or continue if actually
very stupid.
So, we do want to hear President Buhari should just sit down and do his underground like a strategist.
That's what he's doing.
What is the sense of saying it to the
But I never mentioned anybody's name as
What was the essence of that statement? to a support group. I wish he had done it for 3 years. He has done it for a lot.
Assalamu alaikum ya Hausawa. Kuna kallon wani shirin da ake yi akan television Ifako Ijaye television. Shine kowa ke kallon yanzu. Malam Shehu she ke kallo. Halaji Aruna she ke kallo. Maman Kausara he take kallo. Mama Aisha Ifako Ijaye television take kallo. Ku kalle Ifako Ijaye television akan yanan gizo www.ifakoijayetv.com.
Have you subscribed to our YouTube channel? If you haven't, please log on to youtube.com and search for Ifako Ijaye Television Blitz. Click the red button and please do not forget to thumb up. You can also connect with us on any of our social media platforms. Website www.ifakoijayetv.com, Twitter at Ifako Ijaye TV, Facebook Ifako Ijaye TV Lagos, Instagram Ifako Ijaye TV, email address ifakojayetelevision@gmail.com. My name is Mustafa Damola and I endorse Ifakojaye Television. Ifakojaye Television, the pride of the people.
Ifakojaye Television. Ifakojaye Television. Bangba la janta awo ki lumo. Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade oki ojo teye keye.
E ma wo Ifako Ijaye Television. Make sure you wo e ma wo Ifako Ijaye Television. Make sure oh you come back. Make sure oh ko lo lo ni bomi just duro sori www.ifakoijayetelevision.com. Thank you.
My name is Akitunde Oluwaseun and I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifako Ijaye Television.
My name is Oluwafunmilayo Oluwole. I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifako Ijaye Television.
Oruko temi ni Sunday Oma Ladeniyi. I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifako Ijaye Television.
My name is Oluwafemi Sewanipita. I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifako Ijaye Television.
My name is Joseph Olusegun, aka Coded. I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifako Ijaye Television.
My name is Yoda Odukoya. I'm proud of Ifako Ijaye Television.
My name is Roland Odukoya. I am proud of Ifako Ijaye Television.
I'm Dr. Samuel Mustafa. I'm a proud stakeholder in Ifako Ijaye Television.
Ifako Ijaye Television, the pride of the people. Ifako Ijaye Television.
Yes, Ijaye Television onyobula ne lekita. Ari na apoya Ifako Ijaye Television. Acho mama choma onile Ifako Ijaye Television. Mama Ngozi onye wako nele. Mu a papa emeka. Or Ifako Ijaye Television, kanele na www.ifakoijayetv.com. Nele ya, okwe na no, oh yeah.
You are welcome back, viewers at home. We are still on your program, Politics and Perspectives. We've had a lot from our panelists. The $16 billion US from 1999 to 2007, the controversies and the fact sheets. Yes, to every journey, there is always a feast of an end. Yes, so at least I think it's high time we give our panelists to say their opening remarks.
I'm a closing remarks,
rather than let's start from my gentle comrade.
No, are you saying my comrade is not
here? Viewers at home, they know you for nothing. Used to put the exams. Maybe for the fact that people complain and also
it's no longer being. And you guys are complaining again.
I just want to
support what he said before we went on break, that what Buhari owns the populace is to either reinvestigate or open the files that he submitted before and see how they can do justice to this body. Because if some group of people just sat down and embezzled this amount of money in our national purse, is not the best for the country. So what we should encourage is that the present administration should try their best to get to the root of this. And they should not use it as a political weapon to fight opposition. We know Obasanjo has formed Third Force, gang up his people just to face the incumbent president. But that doesn't mean if there are facts and figures. So we want the president to come out here.
So they will not times that they will not see that with Johnson.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you very much. I just want to implore the president to leave as a president. He should take action where action needs to be taken. He shouldn't be coming to the public space for sympathy all the time. It is our people's money and people voted for him based on the fact that he has integrity. So he should be able to live up to that standard. Okay. Secondly, whoever that such stool that President Buhari threw the other day, whoever that thing affected, which is Obasanjo individually, I was expecting not to just refer people to the book. It should come out good with his statements and make his statement known, not for today, but for
eternity
to judge him. Because government cannot keep on dwelling on the same thing. This is the third administration after his administration. So we need to have a final say or conclusion on this particular. They hold the people. In fact, President Buhari holds this duty before the next election. Probably he will even win some sympathy vote based on
may not be total for the election. The
should have raised. You see, one thing is, if you are not ready to fight, don't engage in fighting.
Okay.
So, for your trouble, then you fight.
So, you ready to fight for finish.
Okay, thank you, Congress. Thank you, Congress. But you see, I want to say one thing before we go to the closing. And that fact is that former President Olusegun Obasanjo should come clean, like Comrade rightly mentioned. Because there are a lot of other issues that, you know, borders on this past presidential exorcist. The Malibu oil and many other things like that. Do you know the cement? The Malibu, the cement, and all the rest. And there's one thing that is really bothering me that should bother all of us, whether you belong to PDP or you belong to APC. And that fact is that when it comes to these airlines, they don't want to expose themselves.
Definitely.
If you look at it from this report, you see this thing happened since 2008. I remember very well, 10 years ago, I remember very well that the report caused problems. Even a rowdy session at the House of Representatives, because they didn't want the report to be read. Even if this report was not officially accepted by the House of Representatives, the Illuminated Nature, it released that report. You understand what I'm saying? So the problem is that they don't want us to know, and they are still
the FCC.
The FCC compromised. For how long are we going to be doing this, or are we going to be allowing this? God will help us. You have something to say?
Yeah, I just want to talk to our viewers at home that don't leave all these perspectives, all these topics. With our panelists alone, your perspective is very important.
Very, very important.
We so much appreciate that. Send us your perspectives. Send us
your feedback.
Your feedbacks, your opinions, they are very good. We are expecting them on our social media platforms. Okay. Yes, you can send it to our YouTube channel, Ifakojayi Television Glimpse.
Or you can send it through our website, www.ifakojayitv.com.
Also, you can join us on Facebook, Ifakojayi TV Lagos.
And on Twitter, @ Ifakojayi TV.
Also on Instagram, Ifakojaye TV.
And in case you want to send us an email, our email address is ifakojayetelevision@gmail.com.
Also, there is room for you to WhatsApp us, to send us text message, and also call us on our lines 0805-196-4461. 0805-196-4461.
Or 0703-743-9891. 0703-743-9891. And before we go share, we need to really give credit to those who have been very helpful. Sure. Those who are behind the scene, behind the camera. We want to thank, let's start from Siwanu Femi Peter. Thank you very much. We have Emmanuel Karo Oto. Thank you very much. We also have Oluwafunmi Layo Oluwole and
Samuel
Faloye. Till next week on another topic.
Another episode.
On politics and
perspectives.
On your
favorite channel.
Ifakojaye Television. Thank you very much.